do another weekend of Breezeway. We're down here in Trenton. The cheers at tonight's guest,
Shawn McCullough.
This kind of a catch-up show. We had you on the show
a year ago. I think it was not quite a year. It was in July. Yeah, it was in last July. I was in your place.
Yeah.
It was tequila and cold beer and good times.
Yeah. That was the last time you seen Fred, eh?
I believe it was. I turned around and I felt something cold on my back, and that's what it was, a beard. Thank you, Fred.
That's all it was, a beard.
Have you been busy since we've seen you last? Have you, what have you been up to?
It's been crazy busy, yeah. I've been doing a lot of shows. I'm booked up solid for a year now ahead on my weekends, and so it's been crazy. I did a little trip up to the CCMAs with a good friend of mine, Bree Lawrenson, and we got to do a song that she released to radio that we wrote together with Wayne Foster. So it was an excellent time. Spent the week up there, and yes, a few big things happening.
I got a ton of questions anyway, because we had a chance to talk before we had dinner and had a chance to talk. So this is what you do for a living.
Absolutely, yeah. I've been doing it full time about four shows a week, and I teach guitar one day a week. So it's pretty much like a regular job. So
you work harder.
Yeah, I think I've worked harder at this job just to stay busy than I at any other job. So when you're done singing at the end of the night, it's like running a marathon. So, but I love it. I absolutely love it.
Well, hats off, because it would take a lot of courage and a lot of business sense to be able to support a family, sure, and make a living off of a guitar.
Well, that's it. Yeah, it's a labor of love, I like to call it. So,
what have you got for us? Let's start us off. We got lots of questions for you, but we'll pop back up.
Sure. I'm going to do something. I'm going to start it off a little bit easy here. I'm going to do something Canadian country, folk country. You're going to remember this song from many years back. This is a Ron Hines theme. I just love this song. People ask me, what is your favorite song to play? And this is absolutely it. So I hope you like it.
Silver
Fantastic show there a little while back.
Yeah,
I watched it.
Yeah, it was fun that one too.
Yep. Yeah, you were just saying that you got to watch a full episode. You're busy all the time. You don't get to watch too many. You just got done saying that.
I watched the whole thing and just wanted to let you know your fly was down for part of it. But, but that's okay.
And again, you did mention the Vince Gill.
Oh, absolutely. You sound like Vince Gill, brother. And you play like him too, so that's awesome.
So, songwriting. Last time we were talking about, and it is an anniversary of Fort Max Fire out there.
It is too.
You want to tell the folks, refresh them on the Fort Max song that you wrote?
Sure, I will, absolutely. We kind of going from element to element. This year we're flooding, and last year was fire. But I wrote a song called Fort McMurray Strong. Last year, right around the time everything was going down, and I thought it'd be a cool idea to use it as a fundraising thing for the Red Cross, and it's still available for download on all the digital entities and stuff, but I got great response from the folks all across the country.
Do you know how it did fundraising, just curiosity?
Not yet, no, I have no idea. It's still going on, so I mean, you can still get it, and but it's been featured on CJOH Calgary, and I released it as a single as well, and we're just starting to get, if you know how SoCan works, you release something and then a year later you start seeing residuals come in. So you know, I'm going to add some success with it at West and a bit in Ontario, so it's cool. It's
awesome.
Nice to be able to play your song and get it out to folks that maybe makes a difference in their life, you know.
I bet you did.
I hope so.
You want to play it for us?
Sure, absolutely. I got to remember it first, eh?
I know, I understand that part.
Came from all over this country to chase that Canadian dream. Clothes on our backs, some hope, a tank full of gasoline. And those wildfires brewing like a storm left our town shattered and torn. We'll dust ourselves off, get right back on the feet. Out of the ashes, we shall rise again. strong. We are Canadian. There's a feeling I've got deep inside. It's this thing called Canadian pride. And it runs through my veins like the oil that we pull from this upper ground. When the smoke clears and the fires are all gone, in that darkest hour just before dawn, we'll stand the test of time. We didn't stand alone. And out of the ashes, we shall rise again. We're Fort McMurray strong. Out of the ashes, we shall rise again. We're Fort McMurray strong. We are Canadian. Yeah, we're Fort McMurray strong. We are Canadian.
Songwriting's awesome.
Thank you very much.
And people, how do they get a hold of that song? Do you got a website or?
Actually, if you go on CD Baby or Google Play or you name it, any of the digital download entities, you can find it there, and it's available.
Do you have any other songs available, or just?
Just that one. That was my first real kick at the can. That was the first song I ever released to like Canada-wide country radio. So. I'm broke because of it, but that's okay. That's okay. You're doing a good thing, and
Yeah,
it was. It's just a nice experience to hear. I plan on doing more of that stuff just as in time, you know.
Yeah, for sure.
Playing 4 days a week, I get busy doing that.
Yeah, you can really get tied up a little bit, and you find weird times to write songs, and I do it sometimes in the middle of the night driving back. From a gig, I tend to never listen to the radio because I'm not a huge, it's hit and miss with me, and I know Rob talked about that as well, about radio stuff. I mean, I like some of the stuff and some of the stuff I'm not fond of, and when you're done playing music all night, you kind of, the last thing you want to do is blare music in the car. I just like silence, and then sometimes good ideas come into mind, and sometimes they're not so good.
CP24 for me, I just watch the news. Keeps you away from music. Do you remember the first band name that you
I ever played?
Yeah, the first.
This is going back.
Well, that's what we were hoping.
Oh man, you see it is
that right here?
Back in, I think it was around 1991. I had a band called The Wanted, and it was a trio, and like that. Name has probably been overused many times, but it was a trio. It was fun, and I couldn't play guitar with a crap at that point. But I was okay. I was exceptionally mediocre on the guitar at that point. But we all cut our teeth, and the more you play with other people, right? You get better, and that's the whole point of the music family, right? And we're all in the same boat, right? So
we've met a lot of people doing this little show, a lot of
absolutely.
Yeah, it's
this big little show.
Yeah, the big little show.
Yeah, little show.
What have you got for us? I don't want to pressure you on any song, right? So do you?
Let's do something. I'm gonna do something.
One of my favorite old country songs, and just keep it on that. Speaking of songwriters, Chris Christopherson wrote this song, and he released it as well as Johnny Cash, so I'm sure you know this song. It's all about how Biebs is going to feel after the big bash there.
Well, I woke up Sunday morning with no way. And that beer I had for breakfast wasn't bad, so I had one more for dessert. Then I fumbled through my closet for my clothes and found my cleanest dirty shirt. And I shaved my face and combed my hair, stumbled down the stairs to make a day. Well, I'd smoked my brain the night before on cigarettes, songs that I've been picking. But I lit my furs and watched the small kid cousin at a camp that he'd been camping. Then I crossed the empty street and caught the Sunday smell of someone frying chicken. And it took me back to something that I'd somehow somewhere lost along the way. On a Sunday morning sidewalk, wishing, Lord, that I was stoned. Cause there's something in the Sunday that makes a body feel alone. And there's nothing short of dying half as lonesome as the sound of a sleeping city sidewalk. Sunday morning coming down. In the park I saw daddy with a laughing little girl. He was swinging. Then I stopped beside a Sunday school and listened to the songs that they were singing. Then I headed back for home, somewhere far away and lonely, bell was ringing. And it echoed through the canyons like the disappearing dreams of yesterday. On a Sunday morning sidewalk, I wish you, Lord, that I was stoned. Cause there's something in a Sunday that makes a body feel alone. And there's nothing short of dying is half as lonesome as the sound of a sleeping city sidewalk. It's Sunday morning coming down. Of a sleeping city sidewalk. It's Sunday morning.
I just see him in a Western the other day, too.
Do you know a fellow by the name of Gibby?
Gibby, absolutely.
Okay, well, he says hello. No, I'm just kidding. Gibby says hello. There we have him on the show.
Gibby, how are you?
How you doing, Gibby?
Him and Justin were on.
How's the beers going up there in Sherwood Lake tonight?
They're really cold up. They still got snow in Sherwood Lake, I think, don't they?
Really? Right, you did have a request. You did have a request on there. You might want to say
sure.
Soldier.
Oh, the
Canadian soul.
Yeah, whatever you want, awesome. You can do that.
Yeah. Well, Leslie Merrigan, online up in Sherwood Lake.
Yes.
So Leslie's watching. She requested it. Now, is there, do you want to go into it?
Sure, we can do that.
What
yeah.
You got a story on this one. This is obviously your homegrown, you wrote it.
Yeah.
Song?
Yeah, it was right around the time, actually right after the horrible events on Parliament Hill where Nathan Cirillo was shot, and I tend to write out of emotion a lot. When I write write a song. I can't just sit down and say, today I'm writing a song. I have to have something that's driving me, or if I get bored, I can just say on the drive. But this one kind of struck me really hard, and because I have a lot of friends in the military as well, and I love them to death, and appreciate everything that's been handed to us by the people that sacrifice for us. And so I wrote this song in honor of them. And I'd actually like to send this out to a good friend of ours, an old hunt buddy, Howard Ringel. He was a World War II veteran, and we just lost him a couple of months ago. And so here's to you, Howard.
We landed on the 6th of June on the beaches of some godforsaken land. I held my brother when he took his last breath as he lay there on that sand. War raged on, but we marched to victory. That battle didn't turn the battle card again. But it sure is the stars up in the sky. I'd do it all again. I crawled through fields of blood and mud and all that fire to protect you till the end. They say freedom isn't free, but it's a price I gladly pay again. And I'll carry all your worries on my shoulders, 'cause I'm a Canadian. I'm a Canadian soldier. Deserts wind and rain and snow in the middle of the night. I crawled through bullet stitches, fear of all my friends, to know that devil in me died. And I still see it every night when I close my eyes to sleep. Whoops. One thing I know for sure is can't unsee the things I've seen. But it sure is it starts up in the sky. And I'd do it all again. I crawl through fields of blood and mud and all that fire to protect you till the end. They say freedom isn't free. It's a price I'll gladly pay again. And I'll carry all your worries on my shoulders, 'cause I'm a Canadian. I'm a Canadian soldier. Yeah, I'm a Canadian.
Releasing that for Remembrance Day this year. I played a show, it was a really cool opportunity to play at Ron Ambrose's house last year. If you don't know who she is, she's the conservative interim leader right now, and there happened to be quite a few very important folks in the audience, and one was the critic for Veterans Affairs, so she really liked the song and has asked me to, let her promote it on their website. So I said, well, wait until I get a good version of it recorded, because all I have is like a crappy Android phone video, and it's just not something I want out there, but definitely going to release that. And
that's cool.
Yeah.
Good
for
you. Thank
you. Beautiful.
So anybody can get a hold of you on Facebook, I take it?
Yeah.
Do you have a web page at all?
I don't. You know, I'm really bad at taking care of technology. I'm not techie at all. So, but you can find me on Facebook. I do have a musician's page, but you're probably going to have better luck on my regular Facebook page, because I promote everything there and where I'm playing and what's going on. And I have a Reverb Nation page as well that I really need to desperately do some work to. But when I learn to be more techie.
Yep. Now, when you, the Facebook and your new album or your new comes out, how far will this take? Because doing this yourself is like to make a living out. It's got to be, like, you got to keep songwriting. Is this, you just start for your own name, or you going to play for other bands?
I'm still playing for a few different bands. I do some freelance guitar work, and I play with a girl by the name of Bree Lawrenson. She's a fantastic singer-songwriter from the Ottawa Valley, who's had some great success, and as well as a band called Double Back, and it's basically her backup band, but we have been doing our own thing since way long ago.
You got any gigs coming up? Do you want to?
This Friday, I'm actually playing at the Keystrom in Brockville, Ontario, and that, and I'm actually taking Saturday night off because I have birthdays. My birthday, my son's birthday, my grandson's birthday, and my daughter's birthday. That's all coming up this month, so I kept one Saturday open and said we're going to do a big party, and it's going to be a good time. So. But we have some shows, Blues Fest in Ottawa this year, and Havelock with Bree Lawrenson as well, and lots of stuff going on.
You're not just a country artist, or you don't have a genre that you can call your own.
That's right.
Yeah.
It's kind of confusing if somebody said, what kind of music do you like? I kind of like it all, right?
Yeah, it's either, I got a system that there's only two. It's either good or bad, and it's up to you to make the call on it.
Exactly.
Oh. Yeah. Might not be the nicest way of putting it, but this.
Well, you know, simplifies things.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, we all like country rock.
Oh, yeah. I mean, it's all had its good eras, and I sat out, actually, the one album I recorded, a full album a few years back, and I set out to do a really country-sounding album.
Take me away. price of the job that you've given me. I want you to know that I believe in your song. A rhythm around the harmony. You help me get along. Making me strong. I wanna get lost in the rock and roll. Tap away, yeah. That's my fake drummer. Give me the beat, boys, free my soul. I wanna get lost in the rock and roll. Tap away, yeah. Give me the beat, boys, free my soul. I wanna get lost in the rock and roll. Tap away, yeah.
Fred singing.
Yeah.
I thought I heard something.
Wasn't the Harley starting earlier?
No.
He wasn't crying? I thought he's crying. I don't know.
He only does that when he runs out of beer.
How many more originals do you have? You got like there you
I've got a
song like
I've got about 14 written up for my next album. So I've got somewhere I've probably forgotten the words to a lot of the older ones that I had written, but I've got probably about 30 originals, I think, somewhere in that neighborhood. Trying to write funnier ones and more positive ones. It's easy to write ballads. Everybody can write ballads, and I tend to fall into that trap. I call it a bit of a trap, but sometimes you get gold with one, you know? And I hang around some real characters in West Point, Charlotte Lake, Parham. I think some of the same characters you've been hanging around with, you guys.
Yeah, there's a few up that way.
There's a lot of
talk about characters. He does some songwriting late. His is usually late evenings.
Yeah. Everybody wants me to sing it twice. That was the original, and the only one time you'll hear it. That's off the top of my head.
What have you got for us, Joe?
I wanted to do something fairly upbeat here. Okay. Well, as upbeat as I get anyway with my songwriting. I was down in Cuba about 2-3 months ago and with a bunch of alcoholics. I like to call them alcoholics because I was one of them. And we've all had those mornings where you wake up and say, oh my God, I'm never doing that again. Ooh, where's the Tylenol, right? So I had a day in my room where I wasn't feeling the best, so I thought I'd write this song and hopefully you like it. It's called I'm Never Drinking Again.
Must have been a hell of a night. Cause who the hell is that beside me? And she don't recognize those ceiling tiles. And if by some small miracle I find my pants, swear I'm never drinking again. He fell asleep with his guitar. It looks like someone found a Sharpie, cause there's some dirty pictures on my arm. Please Lord, if you can make this headache go away. Bit my ass. fast, I'll shorten up this jam. But I swear I'm never drinking again.
Because his friend was telling you a few minutes ago about the driving at night kind of thing. I had this idea stuck in my head. It was December 23rd, I do believe, on my way back from playing at Keystone Pub in Brockville. And I had this idea in my head about more alcohol. And I got home and I couldn't sleep, so I wrote the song at about 3 in the morning. So it's called God Made Whiskey.
Tomorrow I might come undone. Now this broken heart is numb. When I wake up, it's gonna hit me. But you're the reason God made whiskey. You're the reason God made whiskey. Oh, I can't drink you back. This ain't magic in my glass. When I'm down to my last shot, you'll still be gone. Curse your name a thousand times. Seem to ease my mind. When I wake up, it's gonna hit me that you're the reason God made whiskey. You're the reason God made whiskey. Yeah, you're the reason God made whiskey.
So someday I'll have one to give you.
Talk about CDs. Somebody give me 2 CDs.
Somebody else did as well. You put me on that spot. Not over there, so I got to remember that.
I just wanted the copy of it.
I thought I'd give you one.
No.
Oh, all right, I'll give you one. Yeah. Fred might have stole it off. I can't remember. He's playing on his phone. Look at. The sign of the time. Fred says, I'll never play on my phone. Would you take a picture?
Yeah, here, Fred. You want a picture?
Yeah, that's
what I do. Yeah, okay. Well, we got to don't worry about the 300 or 400 people at home on
the 300 or 400 people.
500 right now.
Is there 500 people watching? You know, my fly's up. You get her done yet, Fred?
No, we can see it out.
Okay.
Where's your hand?
You did say you wanted a picture.
Yeah. Well, I think we should every show. We get away from that, but it's good to have a memory.
Okay. Do you have family get you started in music, or like what was the inspiration to get you going?
Well, actually, yeah. My parents were musicians. My dad was a fiddle player, and my mother played guitar. And actually, I have both dad's fiddle and mom's guitar at home. And I can't play the fiddle, though. That's the unfortunate part. I tried it. I can play a bit of mandolin, and I get the concept, but I tried one night out on the porch, and I had every feral cat within 5 miles at the house, so it was not pretty, but no, they absolutely got me started, and when I was born, about that time, mom had a heart attack, so they quit playing out and stuff, and but they taught me how to play around the kitchen table, right? So Uncle Bob would show up, wasted out of his mind back in the day, back when you take the back roads and have a pint or two, and he knew a million songs. You know, a million songs, and they were so good about it. They just let me play along. I started playing with like a dobro style open tuning because my hands were really small and that. And they just play all night. He'd show up at maybe 11 o'clock at night, and he'd go till 4 in the morning. And you either played long or you didn't sleep. So I learned how to play guitar.
And you were saying the generations are still learning and still playing. When we talked earlier, you were saying that the next generation is playing a lot of old country coming up, and
it's coming full circle, I believe. I think so. We're getting a lot of really, really hot guitar players coming out, like Brad Harpel is one of them, and just amazing picker, and Rob Hood over there, Mr. Rob Hood of the Robin Hood fame. Just so many, and
you might want to put it in your guys' minds if you want to jam a tune together. Like, we're not opposed to that.
Absolutely, so, that would be good.
So, and Beats has got a spot top there too, Rob. So it's
I
just saw it, but I don't want to put anybody on the spot. If you don't feel like it,
that's a great idea. That's a great idea. And we're starting to see on radio some of the old ways coming back. I mean, we went through a very stale period. That's my opinion. It's been very stale on radio with the formula, like they like to call it, the writing formula. And now we're getting guys that are coming out like Chris Stapleton that are changing the game a bit. You know,
his name gets spoken a lot.
Yeah, he's very good with lyrics. You know, it's not it's full of surprises.
Probably as far as on the show, Chris Stapleton's name has been brought up.
Yeah, Starkly Simpson's another one.
Oh yeah.
Whitey Morgan don't get enough credit for that.
You're a big fan, Whitey.
And Cody Jinks.
Yeah.
James
Johnson.
Yeah. Oh, Jimmy Johnson, yeah. That's the kind of guys that's still country to me. And I listen to it on the Outlaw channel.
Oh, that's
where they play it most of the time.
Yeah.
I should send one of mine, maybe play it on that. I'm an Outlaw channel.
You are an Outlaw.
I clean up it.
Oh, we have a couple of questions. Got a couple requests online, man.
What do we? What do we have?
We have Fight and Soldier's Last Letter.
Oh, I can do Fight. That's one of mine.
Yeah,
I can do that for sure.
That's nice, hey, to have somebody request in your own songs.
Such a great feeling. It's, and this is such a great venue. And thank you very much to the Harp House for letting us do this. And you guys,
yes, very much.
Oh, my goodness.
People, the food down here, the service is wonderful. Great sound system to be for musicians to come in and play. It's a great spot. We're going to have them on the show in a couple weeks.
I'm going to tune in.
All right, you got one? You got your request?
Yes, I got to tune down. Anyway, this is kind of a special song to me. As I said earlier, I write out of emotion, and this is a song I wrote for my dad. We lost him actually. It was 5 years ago on May 5th to cancer, and this is the story of his fight. I hope you like it. You could almost hear a pin drop. Doctor walked into the room. When we heard the words we didn't want to hear, I watched my dad turn to stone. He said the best we can do is try and slow it down if you really want to try. Just clench his fist and said, now I'll be damned if I just lay here and die. He said, I'll fight with everything I have till my last breath.
sons and for my daughters, and for those who passed. And I'm gonna go down swinging, and you know I won't go quietly into the night. I'm gonna fight. Next few months I walk that mountain, old man, just fade away to nothing. Now those sleepless nights and late night talks, they really taught me something. He said sometimes you gotta stand your ground, or you might take wood on the chin. Just bite your lip and pull your hat down, son. Turn and face the wind. He said, fight with everything you have till your last breath. Fight for your sons and for your daughters and for those who passed. Always go down swinging. Don't go quietly into the night. The daughters and for those who pass, I'm gonna go down swinging, and I know I won't go quietly into the night. I'm gonna fight. Yeah, I'm gonna.
That somebody's always going to be there, right? So,
for sure.
And I'll tell you.
It's for sure. Bill Ritchie, I want to say, Bill's watching. He started his treatments today. Fight the good fight, Billy. This song here. Should give you. I don't know, buddy. Praying for you, Billy. Hang in there, bud. Keep fighting.
Well, we did it. We talked Rob into coming up and having a tune. You guys chat, pick out a tune while we're getting this plugged in and ready to go. Great songwriter, great guitar player, and guitar player of the year, I heard.
I was a nominee back in my day with Jason.
Nominee for
guitar player of the year.
Yeah.
But I mean,
and that was playing for Jason McCoy.
Yeah, I mean, I took it.
But
for what it was, I didn't win, but it was nice to be nominated.
So. Oh, yes, that's right. Especially when somebody in the ballot is not us. I didn't do the homework on that. I'm not taking credit for it. Somebody else probably has questions more than what we got for you.
What do you got for us?
I think we're going to do a Merle tune, I think.
Oh, yeah.
Are you doing a Merle tune, Rob?
Sounds good to me.
I don't think anybody's going to argue with Merle Haggard.
You want to introduce Rob?
This is, ladies and gentlemen, again, he was just on a couple weeks, but this is Mr. Rob Hood, joining Shawn McCullough, and I'm getting off of here.
Thank you very much.
He had a few too many that night, and he's just been kind of around the corner there. So.
I was sleeping in my cousin Richie's car for the last 3 weeks, and I just woke up and stumbled in here.
Singer? I'll watch it. Woo!
first thing I remember knowing was that lonesome whistle blowing and the youngest dream of growing up to be riding on a freight train in town, not knowing where I'm bound. No one can stand where I could find a child. What an only rebel child from a family meek and mild. My mama said, no.
I'm so high, I'm low.
Just let me know when they're in, where and when they. I'll fill up the cooler and I'll be there.
Decent.
Oh, we're having fun down here. Cheers.
It's had a great time.
Wish I hadn't decided.
I understand what you're talking about now, Rob.
It's
that style of picking he was just doing there, I say. Keep it up.
Good stuff. I think Chris can have you then.
Back in tune, there we go.
Back in tune?
Nothing like a floppy G-string.
You ain't kidding.
You busted
yours. No, it wasn't good this time. Usually it's my G-string I busted. Last one was the D-string. Sure.
Oh, that kind of was shocking to me, too. I'm glad that you were shocked a little bit.
Oh, no, no, I don't wear a G-string. Jesus, I think somebody would think I was smuggling chestnuts or something. That's it. Just a, well, you know, a button on a fur coat.
So what have you got for us? You ever got any fur coat songs?
Oh, no fur coat songs.
I might just write a funny one now called A Button on a Fur Coat.
Oh, yeah. What, do you think it's something old? Something
Fred, do you have a song?
If, when Sean, you know, old, when Sean, when you're by yourself, Sean, we talked about this earlier, when you're by yourself, and you've got time to play guitar, feel like playing guitar. What is a tune that that normally doesn't get played in public that just you would give it a whirl?
No, just kidding.
Hey, I love that song.
That's the same one I do.
I like just messing around, like thinking about the old times and the kitchen parties and stuff. And I like playing some of the old stuff. So
right.
One that I don't do very often. I can't say I never play it, but I don't do it in the pubs very often, because it's as old as the hills. Older than me, I think this song is, and I can't remember who did this one, but my brother knows, because we play it sometimes together. So it's an old tune called From a Jack to a King.
Ned Miller.
Ah, there you go.
From a Jack to a King. Jack to me, with no regrets, I stacked the cards last night. Lady Luck played her hand just right, made me king in your heart. For just a little while, thought that I might lose the game, but now just in time I saw the twinkle. From Jack to a King, from loneliness to a red ring, I played an ace and a water free, made me king in your heart. For just a little while, I thought that I might lose again. Just in time I saw a twinkle in her eyes. From the Jack to the King, from loneliness to everything, I played an ace and won a dream, and made the king of the heart.
You say your brother plays as well?
Yeah, my brother Dave plays bass, and actually he showed me a bunch of chords when I was a kid too, and I like to tease him because he's the older, less refined look version of me, but anyway, he's a gem of a human being, and we get together. He plays in a band called Red Rose Express, and they'd be great great folks for you all to check out sometime. Dave and Joe Saunders, Claire Adams, and Mauro Piazzi, they're all great guys.
And where are they located at?
Out of Kingston area. So yeah, they play all old school classic country, and it's really, really well done. Great three-part harmony.
Really, very nice. Yeah. It's good to know. Yeah.
Absolutely. I think it'd been dangerous if we had to live close together.
It might.
Oh my God, we would have went through a lot of strings and pranks.
I think you got you're on to something there. Yeah. Yeah, I think so.
Song title, Strings and Pranks.
See, we're writing one right now. We're going to have the radio off on the way home. And a picture of him and his G-string in my head.
Oh, stop that.
Oh my God.
That's good.
Got a couple requests.
What's it called? What do we got?
We have Roger Miller, Dang Me, and Sonny's Dream.
We did Sonny's Dream.
Sonny's Dream was the real one.
I don't know Dang Me, but I do know another Roger Miller.
Yes, sure.
And I want to say thanks to all the viewers out there, and I know from Newfoundland, probably Kathleen Pittman's watching, maybe Joe McCrary down there in Illinois in the Corn Belt, or it might be
Joe made a nice little dish there, too. You see that?
He did, yeah. He's quite handy. He went catfishing there the other day. He got a good string. But thanks for being a fan all the way down here in Illinois. You keep saying those guys are hilarious.
Yes, yeah, you're doing well, very well.
Just a real life thing with us. Yeah.
What you see is what you get.
We spent hours rehearsing.
Yeah.
When did the choreographed moves come yet? Like I saw you guys doing some interpretive dance before.
Well,
you
know.
I work on them after about a 26 or tequila. That's when I get really good at my calisthenics.
That's what's missing. I remember tequila the last time.
Yeah, you know, I don't know who left that there, so I had to drink it up because it had a bad and an expiry date on it. I hate anything to go bad. So.
Well, it's you know what it is, the lemon that makes it go bad.
That's what I thought, because it made that. More balls, pucker up.
You were going to use salt, see, until you deserve it.
Exactly.
Okay. You got Roger Miller's?
I got a Roger Miller tune. And for the folks that were wanting to hear Sonny's Dream, I believe you can watch this over again. It's going to be on YouTube,
yes,
right?
We'll post it up on YouTube in a couple days.
Perfect.
And you go on to In the Breezeway, the Facebook page. And you can also anytime scan back through. We put it up on YouTube. It's easier to find a couple weeks ago or whatever, because we post quite a bit out there on our wall. So
absolutely, okay. So cool. Here's the Roger Miller tune, and forget me, I got to do the killer intro bass part. Here we go. Fingers here. Dreadless folks say no way. We're on the no cooler pets. I ain't got no cigarettes. I put 2 hours of cushion but by 8 to 12 foot I'm a man who means by no means king of the road. Third box car midnight train destination Maryland. Oh, worn out suits and shoes. Don't play no union dues. I spoke old stories I had found. Short, but not too big. I'm a man who means by no means king of the road. I know every engineer on every train. And all the children, and all the names. Every in every town, and every lot the landlord knows around, I see Dreadless folks say, "Don't run." The rooms to let 50 cents. No fun, no food, no pets. I ain't got no cigarettes. I'll put 2 hours of pollution from the flies. 8 to 12 feet. Means by no means king of the road. I know every engineer on every train, and all the children, and all of the names. Every hand out in every town, every life that I'm known, so round I sing. Dreadless
graceful sight. The room's to let for descent. No phone, no food, no pets. I ain't got no cigarettes, but 2 hours of vision burned by some April 12th. A man who means by no means king of the road.
Friends are watching that.
I bet they are. And it's nice for you to be able to watch that too.
It's incredible. It's nice.
I owe $20 because of Ottawa in the last round. Bossy, you know. I'm buying him a dozen beer, I guess. I'll get him next year.
I bet you will.
But Roger Miller, I was talking about there, that song there. He's a hell of a songwriter as well.
Absolutely.
And I was singing one of his the other day, Heartache for Keepsake. We'll record that. Yeah. I was doing it for my mom, just King Wells also recorded. We're still working on training my mom on the, not on the show, but I like to do a short video of maybe just being training my mom. Something to leave behind in the order.
Well, there's great memories too, eh? You go back over, those kids go back over.
Absolutely.
Well, it's quite a thing. Great memories.
Yeah, our grandkids are watching me once in a while and they go, they'll see it with somebody else, like maybe yourself singing a song. They like, that's Papa's song, because they hear me sing it. And I don't know, it's not my song.
Tell them what it is.
Yeah.
Sweet, though, sweet.
We got time for a couple more, if you do.
Sure, I'm game.
And then we'll try to get one off camera.
Sure.
We're going to all videotape it so it's not live up online. So
yeah.
Just something we started last week with the...
We should get another picture on the deer phone at the end, too. That's awesome. Showed my backside. I think my belly's hanging. The camera adds 50 pounds on here. All right, what do you got?
What do I have?
Just thinking out loud here.
Know any George Jones?
I don't do any George. I mean, I do
from time to time, but you do a way better George Jones than I do.
Well, George Strait or?
George Strait. I don't do any George Strait, but I do Waylon Jennings. Oh, Jennings, why not?
There we go.
And I'm not man enough to sing it down where he does, so I got to capo it up more.
Or even a Keith Whitley, if you know any Keith, or honor him today.
I could probably get through a Keith. Why not? Let me do that. I don't think we've done this one. I haven't done this one in years. It's not one I normally sing, but...
I've got 28 years today.
Oh, wow. Hopefully I don't screw the words up. It's for Mr. Keith Whitley.
Baby, I've been fooled. holding on all this time. Even now in my arms, knowing he's on your mind, I keep hoping someday you see the light. Let it begin tonight. Don't close your eyes. Don't close your eyes. Let it be me. Don't pretend it's him. It's some fantasy. Darling, just once, let yesterday go. You'll find more love than you've ever known. Just hold me tight when you love me tonight. Don't close your eyes. Just hold me tight when you love me tonight. Don't close your eyes.
Awesome.
Good here. That was what we were just talking about in playing with Jason McCoy. That must have been some good times, too.
It was a hoot. I spent 2 years just going from one end of the country to the other, and played every major arena there was, plus every bar, I think, in there. First few months were bars, and then when he got some notoriety, had a couple of songs in the top 10, it was bigger shows. We ended up doing a tour with Martina McBride and John Barry, and we started in Vancouver and ended up in Halifax. So we played 30 shows in 33 days, and we drove every leg of the way ourselves in a motorhome. So it was in January, and all the other bands had their tour buses and drivers, and there was 9 of us in a motorhome driving, and it was so cold. I remember up in Grand Prairie, it was so cold. It was the side door froze shut. It was like iced up. So it was. But I wouldn't trade it for, you know, anything. It's just interesting.
You'd do it again.
Oh, I'd do it in a heartbeat, yeah.
I know. I wish I could do it.
Such good times. And my highlight was playing Massey Hall. That was
really
unbelievable feeling. It was great. But, you know, life and family gets in the way. And not in the way, but life and family happens, and you have to be there. So I had to leave the road. I had a new baby. My daughter was born. And again, I wouldn't trade that for, you know, I'd do it again in 100 times, you know.
The Play Massey Hall itself is I've seen Alison Krauss there, and I've seen Steve Earle there also, so I mean, I've seen some pretty big hitters, and that's so nice to see them.
Steve's on my bucket list. I want to see him live.
I've seen when he came in doing, what's his name, Steve's?
Towns Van Zandt?
Yes, he came in just him and slinging the guitar, acoustic guitar. Buddy's thought there was going to be quite a show, like with the Dukes or. It was awesome for me to see him acoustic.
And I think the older we get, the more we appreciate the stripped down varieties of these big artists as well. I really love just watching it happen. You hear all the pops and the squeaks of the strings and that, and I just love it. And I think that should come back in recording too, and I think it slowly is, you know, people aren't overdubbing as much, and you know, a few of them aren't.
No, there's nothing like live music either.
No,
but exactly.
So what would you like to leave everybody Facebook world and down here cheaters with? We got one more dude, but we're going to do it off of the film after the
Whalen?
Yeah, let's do
the
Whalen one.
All right.
Decent. You guys should stay up and help me with this one.
Decent.
You got a good Whalen helper right there.
Decent.
All right, let's do this. You want Newton G or A? You probably want Newton.
I can do the Whistler.
I've done this one on this only in singing in the truck, so you start out and see what it works.
The only two things in life that make it worth living
guitars and tune good for feeling limp.
I don't need my name in the marquee lights.
I got my song and I got you with me tonight. Baby, it's time we got back to the basics of life.
Those diamond rings, buy some boots, some faded jeans, and gold.
This golden tie is choking me, but in your high society, we'll cry. We've been so busy keeping up with the Joneses, four car garage, and we're still building up. Maybe.
To entertainers and live musicians.
On weekends, they've got entertainment down here. They're entertaining all the time. And hats out to places that have live music. I mean,
yeah. If you want live music, you got to get out and support it.
Yes.
If not, it dies. So folks that are watching should be out listening.
And I can't wait for your CD to...
That's a long walk from Newfoundland.
Evolve.
I'm hoping in the next 6 months or so I should have something out for you.
Awesome.
Yeah, awesome. Yeah,
yeah. Well, keep us posted on.
Yeah, we'll put it on the Facebook.
And everybody, get in to check this. If you, I know that on the video it's pretty good and all that, but to see you live and to watch it, do your stuff, it's amazing. So yeah.
Thank you very much, and all my friends out there in Facebook land. Tell your friends to like the page here, Franny and Beeps in the Breezeway.
Well, I just had a look at the amount of views on there, and it's quite impressive. There's a little bells on that there right now. It just wants this one. So.
That's awesome.
Hit the share button.
Hit the share button until next week's guest. Country Spice.
Country Spice is coming in.
And we're going to have him in the studio.
In the studio, yeah.
That's... where the tequila happens.
The tequila may be back up next Tuesday.
And I have to be a spectator.
Come on in. There's always room for something.
Okay, until next week, keep your beer on ice and your sticks handy for her.
poking them toads if you can find them under the water. See you next week.